Thank you. That concludes the debate on legislative consent motion to the Environment Bill. It is now time to move on to the next item of business, which is an urgent question, and I call Paul Sweeney.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. To ask the Scottish Government what actions it will take to resolve the ongoing pay dispute between ScotRail and its workers in light of the announcement of strike action during COP26.
Minister Graham Day.
Presiding Officer, talks with the trade unions over the general grades pay claim took place today, and discussions are planned tomorrow with ASLEF. And despite a backdrop of significant financial challenges faced by the rail sector, there are reasonable offers on the table which, through pragmatic and meaningful discussions about efficiencies and modernisation, could lead to an agreement being reached. Today's talks have just adjourned and are scheduled to resume on Thursday. Any cancellations as a result of industrial action not only have the potential to undermine the recovery of our rail services, but also impact on vital revenue streams from ticket sales. And while we support the right of every worker and trade union to engage with our employers to seek a pay deal, COP26 is Scotland and Glasgow's chance to showcase the key role we see for rail in our sustainable future on a world stage. We obviously hope that staff and the unions will understand the importance of the moment and will work with ScotRail to resolve this dispute. And we're obviously encouraged by the fact that the talks have adjourned until later this week.
Paul Sweeney.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I refer to my register of interest as a member of the Unite Trade Union. In the past couple of days, 20 ScotRail employees in depots across the country were sent home, effectively locked out of their workplaces, for refusing to operate machinery that they did not have necessary accreditation or training to operate. This comes against the backdrop of the continued and ongoing pay disputes that the Minister referred to. As a result, Unite Trade Union members have overwhelmingly backed strike action in October and November, including during COP26. That means 3 days of strike action will take place on Scotland's railways during the most important climate conference in history. So can I ask the Minister, does he endorse Abellio's decision to send those workers home using anti-trade union tactics which fly in the face of the Scottish Government's Fair Work Convention, simply for exercising their right to withdraw their labour?
Mr Sweeney, having declared his interest, is entitled to interpret what may or may not have happened in whatever way he sees fit. I have spoken directly to Unite this morning on this matter. There were a number of staff members who may have found themselves in that situation, and we've raised this issue with ScotRail. But what I would say to the Chamber is, in an industrial dispute like this, there is a lot of rhetoric, there is a lot of assertion, and there is a lot of claim. What we need here, Presiding Officer, is for calm heads, for people to get round the table and work constructively to resolve everything within this situation.
Paul Sweeney.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. Whilst I welcome the hint that there may well be a revised offer, with respect to the Minister, I tend to trust the integrity of workers and their trade union representatives to tell the truth in this matter. And while the Government has made an effort to respond, which I commend, it seems to me that it's trying to shut the stable door after the horse has bolted. The situation should never have been allowed to deteriorate to this point. The fact of the matter is that the Government has steadfastly refused for a matter of over 18 months to engage meaningfully with this pay dispute. Workers' morale is at an all-time low, and they've been left with no option but to vote for this strike action. This isn't a bolt from the blue. It is not a malicious act. It's a result of sustained behaviour that is unacceptable by the employer. We now face the prospect of Scotland being an international laughingstock, as delegates of the COP26 conference can't use public transport because of Abellio's intransigence and this government's seeming indifference. On that basis, can I ask the Minister what the next steps are if this revised pay offer that's currently under discussion is refused by the trade unions? Also, will they make it clear to Abellio that the lockouts, which they are lockouts indisputably, are totally unacceptable? And will they instruct Abellio to halt this practice before the situation escalates any further?
Yes. Minister.
And once again, Presiding Officer, I refer back to the declaration of interest that Mr Sweeney made. And therein lies part of the problem. This is a dispute that needs to be resolved by everybody coming together to resolve it. I've encouraged over a long period of time, I should remind them I've only been in post for 5 months, all sides here to engage constructively, and I'm pleased to see the approach that's been taken today. It is in no one's interest for this dispute to continue, and it is in no one's interest for it to impact COP. So rather than standing there with the greatest respect to Mr Sweeney portraying one side of this argument, I do hope that he will come away from this chamber encouraging the trade unions to engage constructively, as I have done with them and with ScotRail, to get this resolved and we all move on.
John Mason.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I wonder if the Minister can reassure us that he will be encouraging ScotRail management to settle this dispute within the budget they have, because we know that passenger revenues are down and we do not want to be switching more money out of the NHS into the railways.
Minister.
Presiding Officer, I'm not going to inflame the situation in any way by talking about the nature of the discussions that took place today, because I do hope that they have moved on in the course of the afternoon. But what I will reassure the member about is that the settlement that's being discussed, the resolution that's being discussed, would be affordable within the existing rail budget.
Graeme Simpson.
Thank you. The Minister is right that it takes two sides to resolve a dispute, but it's within his gift to get involved. Can I ask if he will be taking direct part in the talks tomorrow, and if not, why not?
Minister.
Well, as I pointed out to the member, if he'd been listening, the talks adjourned this afternoon and they don't resume until Thursday. Tomorrow's discussions are with ASLEF. It's not for the role of a government minister to be directly involved in talks of this nature. This is for the employers and the unions to do. But the fact is, we have got to this point because of the encouragement and support of this government to get a resolution. And I reiterate today, both sides need to get around this in a constructive manner. And if they do, I believe we can get this resolved.
Thank you. That concludes the urgent question. Members, last week a point of order was raised about the provision of information, including draft regulations, in respect of the vaccine certification scheme. I undertook to look at the matter in more detail and to return to the Chamber if I thought it necessary. As members know, it is my view that information should always be provided to the Parliament in as timorous a fashion as possible. Members may wish to be aware that last session a protocol was put in place with the Scottish Government that confirms the processes for scrutiny of COVID measures and the information that will be provided to the Parliament to better enable that scrutiny. This includes the provision of draft regulations to the COVID Committee on a Wednesday afternoon following any statement from the Scottish Government. This protocol was agreed last session as part of a package of enhanced security measures, and I wish to inform Parliament that I plan to invite the Bureau to review the protocol to ensure that it remains content with its operation. Now, the next. Excuse me. Thank you, members. We have arrived potentially at decision time earlier than we might have expected, and I would invite the Minister to move a motion without notice to bring forward decision time to now.
Moved, Presiding Officer.
Help if the microphone's locked.
Do our members consent to agree that decision time be brought forward to now? Thank you. The next item of business is decision time. There are three questions to be put as a result of today's business. I remind members that if the amendment in the name of Donald Cameron is agreed, then the amendment in the name of Monica Lennon will fall. The first question is that amendment 1512.1 in the name of Donald Cameron, which seeks to amend motion 1512 in the name of Michael Matheson on legislative consent to the Environment Bill, be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The Parliament is not agreed, therefore we will move to a vote and there will be a short suspension to allow members to access the digital voting system.